I'd like to know, the offensive was great today, a couple of days ago. You were talking about that because actually you mentioned an example you lived many years ago. But today the offensive was the key to win that game. Could you tell me something about it?
I will, and it was against a really good starter that has good history against our team. And so sometimes I say it, somebody else that has really good history against us and we don't hit them, it means we're due to hit them. Because most people talk about the 0 for 7s or 0 for 6s or hitting 100. I say if it's 0 for 6, 0 for 7 or hitting 100, that means we're due to hit because they're good hitters. And our team's a good hitting team, and they showed it today. They hit a very good starter, and it was 1 through 9. We had a full lineup, and that's how you win games in stretches. You win some games because one hitter gets hot. But to win a game in stretches, you need your whole lineup swinging the bat. And that's what we did.
Le preguntábamos sobre la ofensiva de hoy, sobre todo porque habíamos tenido unos cuantos días, bueno, hace par de días, incluso él mencionó una historia el día que no pudimos batear para conseguir la victoria en esa ocasión. Y dice que nuestro equipo ofensivamente es muy bueno. Y eso tiene un valor especial porque cuando tú tienes jugadores en general ofensivos, cuando tú tienes una alineación que puede hacer ofensiva, es mucho mejor que tener a un jugador que esté caliente, que esté bateando, porque al final lo que da victorias y lo que hace conseguir rachas de victorias es precisamente tener una buena alineación, unos buenos jugadores ofensivos, y ese es nuestro caso y fue lo que pudimos ver hoy en el terreno de juego. Tenemos una pregunta de Jordaniel Abreu. Adelante.
Hi, Dave. Great game today. My question is, David Paulino did a great job in today's game. Does they just continue to use him as the mid-game pitcher?
As I've said before in these interviews, it really isn't my decision. And David Paulino has made us use him in these situations because he's pitching well. He gets both sides of the plate out. He throws strikes. He competes. He can throw multiple innings. So it's not like, you know, I'm deciding to use him. He's forcing us to use him for the right reason. And it was, I would think, the most important part of the game when he came in and saved inherited runners, and gave us an opportunity to swing the bat and get a lead.
Sobre la pregunta de Jordaniel, de si va a seguir utilizándose a David Paulino en ese rol de lanzador en entradas intermedias, dice el dirigente que se ha visto forzado en utilizar a David Paulino en esas situaciones, que prácticamente no depende de él, sino que él ha estado lanzando bastante bien y ha sido el jugador que, el lanzador, que sale y se presenta a sacar los outs en momentos importantes y es un lanzador competitivo que tira muchos strikes y que también puede lanzar múltiples entradas y por eso ha estado lanzando estas situaciones del juego porque hoy, por ejemplo, fue importante el momento en el que salió y pudo hacer el trabajo lanzando esas dos entradas. Tenemos una pregunta de David Hernández. Adelante.
Saludos, Dave. Buen partido. Me gustaría que usted como dirigente me explicara el plan de trabajo que le trazó a los muchachos al momento de estar en el home plate, junto, claro está, con el coach de bateo para poder atacar a Espino, quien había lucido dominante frente a los Leones en las últimas salidas.
He said, if you can explain, if you design a work plan to face up the pitcher, the name of Toro's pitcher, I don't remember now.
Espino.
But that guy, because we didn't have good results in the past game against him.
It's a good question. That's what I said is, when you don't have good results on somebody, sometimes we can look at it negatively that you can't hit them. I like to look on it, and I think our team looks on it. I'm pretty sure they do, that we're due to hit that guy. And the only other thing off of that is, when you get to be a good hitting club, when things are going good for you offensively, it doesn't matter who you face. You can face Espino. They could bring Scherzer down here, and you're going to hit him. Then again, when you're going through stretches where you don't hit, I could go to the mound and get somebody out. So it's just a game of baseball. It's really an interesting game, and it's so much fun, and it's a really good question. But we were bound to hit that guy, and we brought our bats today.
Dice que en realidad nosotros somos un equipo ofensivo, reitera esa situación, y que no importa con qué pitcher se enfrente nuestro equipo, va a tratar de hacer el trabajo, no importa si es Espino, no importa si es otro jugador, y es lo que pasó hoy. Lamentablemente en otras ocasiones no se habían podido conseguir buenos resultados, pero eso no implica que vamos con una perspectiva negativa a enfrentar a un lanzador como este, sino que como equipo ofensivo, exitoso, de manera ofensiva, pues tratamos de hacer el trabajo y fue lo que pudimos hacer hoy. Pero no importa el lanzador que tengamos que enfrentar, él confía en el trabajo que pueda hacer el equipo. Tenemos a Arvin González. Adelante, Arvin.
Gracias, Michael. Hi, Mr. Jones.
Hola.
I got two questions. First, what was your take on Sullivan in his first game? And also, how difficult is for you as a strategist to deal with someone like Gary Sanchez?
The first question is, I didn't know Brett before 2 days ago, when all of a sudden he got approved by his testing and ready to play for us. He came ready with all the work that he did in San Diego. Good reports from the Tampa people like Blake Butera, our quality control coach, on who knew him, who had him in the minor leagues. And he was just what they told us, is that this is an athlete behind the plate, a guy that brings some ability to swing the bat at the plate, run on the bases, and catch a game well. And the thing is, he caught six new pitchers today. I think we went six, maybe only five. But he had never caught those guys before in his life, and that's quite a testament to how good a catcher he is. And he'll add to the mix of catching we have. We've got Wilken, we've got Julio Rodriguez, we got Charlie Valerio, and we got Audrey Perez. He's now another guy that's going to catch for us and help us win games. And then the other question you said was Santos. I didn't understand that question.
It's okay. I'm going to say it again. I ask you about how difficult it's for you as a manager to deal with someone like Gary Sanchez.
Oh, Gary Sanchez, I'm sorry. Because I'm so involved with my team. When you mentioned somebody else, I understood Espino. It's a really good question, because that's a very good big league player. And he's actually with the Yankees, and in the States, I'm with the Yankees. I'm only Ruhe now, red. But in the States, I'm with Gary Sanchez, and I'm glad he's a catcher for the New York Yankees and helps us go for a championship next season. When you make mistakes, Gary Sanchez hits you. And each of those pitchers that gave up mistakes, Harmon and Cordero, it was mistakes. When Harmon executes his pitch, when Cordero executes his pitch, Sanchez is out, just like Yamako Navarro, just like Bruja, just like Adames, just like that whole lineup there. Florimon, Hansen, that lineup's a really good lineup. And when our guys execute those pitches, they're not going to score off us. We made two mis-executed pitches, two to Sanchez, and then we walked some people. Outside of that, our pitching was really good.
Arvin le hizo dos preguntas. La primera fue sobre Sullivan, sobre la integración de Sullivan y cómo maneja con la situación de un nuevo jugador dentro del equipo. Y dice él que hace un par de días no conocía a Sullivan, pero que tuvo buenos reportes sobre él, lo que hacía, las condiciones como jugador, cómo corría las bases, el jugador defensivo y ofensivo que era. Y bueno, pues ha podido irse adaptando porque tenía las condiciones para jugar, tenía la información de que podía hacer el trabajo y así lo ha hecho. En el caso de la otra pregunta fue sobre Gary Sánchez, cómo maneja él el tema de los lanzadores para enfrentar a un bateador de grandes ligas como Gary Sánchez. Y dice que, bueno, él se concentra en los jugadores de nuestro equipo. Pero en el caso de Gary Sánchez sale a hacer el trabajo como cualquier otro jugador. Hoy tuvimos la situación con Harman, que se equivocó con un picheo cuando le conectó el doble. Y lo mismo que con Jimmy Cordero cuando le conectó el jonrón. Pero fueron errores que sucedieron. En general, los Toros tienen muy buenos jugadores, como los que ya él mencionó. Es un buen line-up y nuestros lanzadores buscan salir a hacer el trabajo independientemente cuál sea el jugador al que enfrenten. Tenemos la pregunta de Enrique Ramírez. Adelante, Enrique.
Good night, Mr. Yaus. What has the team worked on offenses for the improvement seen in the last two games?
What they work on has been going on for a month now. I'd like to say that there was something done in 2 days that made us swing the bat a little better. It's just a little bit day to day. You put in a consistent practice program, you put in a consistent plan for your approach individually in the team, and you just keep working off your at-bats from the day before and a couple days before. And if you're a good hitter, if you're a good hitting team, that's what's going to come about. I believe we're a good hitting team, and it showed today, showed yesterday, late in the game, and I believe we're going to, this will be a springboard to us showing what an offensive club we are, because the Toros is coming into the game was that they were the best pitching team in the league.
La pregunta iba en torno al...
La mejora en
el equipo de hace 2 días, exactamente, sí. Y la respuesta de nuestro dirigente fue que no puede decir exactamente qué mejoró desde hace 2 días hacia acá, pero que sí el equipo ha estado haciendo mejor y es lo que trata de hacer día a día. Por eso él habla del partido del día y no de lo que pasó hace días anteriores, porque cada día se tratan de corregir cosas, de mejorar, de ser mejor equipo cada día, y bueno, pues es lo que ha resultado desde hace 2 días hacia acá, pero no siempre se puede conseguir la victoria, pero se han hecho las cosas muy bien en estas últimas 2 jornadas para conseguir esos triunfos. Tenemos otra pregunta de Jordaniel. Adelante, Jordaniel.
Dave, the players have been hitting well in the last few games. The strategy of using Franchi Cordero's leadoff hitter has worked wonderfully. Did they just find the right place in the lineup for his players to use?
And it's almost like the question earlier about David Paulino. I didn't make any decision on David Paulino pitching. He has shown that he needs a pitch. I didn't make any decision on Franchi Cordero hitting in the lineup, because I don't care what his numbers say. His at-bats and his approach and swinging the bat have been very, very good. We were trying to get... He was forcing us to get him up in the lineup to get more at-bats. And it just jumped at us by the way he was playing that let's use him first or second. And there was some input from the front office analytics group. There was some input from Gilbert Gomez at the alternate site. He was watching and does some planning for us. And then with Jorge Mejia, the hitting coach, and both Ramon Santiago and Blake Butera, we thought it was really good to use Franchi and Lopez at the top two spots to set up the middle of the order to have people on base. And it's been fruitful these 2 days, and we'll see how it goes the rest of the time.
La pregunta que le hace Arvin es sobre tener a Franchi Cordero en el tope de la alineación, iniciando la alineación, lo que ha sucedido en los últimos 2 días y ha coincidido con la victoria del equipo. Y dice David Jaus que la situación de Franchi Cordero es como la que sucede con David Paulino, con David Paulino, que no es él quien decide que, bueno, va a abrir, va a lanzar en el medio del partido en esta situación, sino que los coaches del equipo, Gilbert Gómez, Ramón Santiago y los demás que mencionó, pues ven que puede funcionar mejor teniendo esos 2 primeros lugares de la alineación para Otto López y para Franchi Cordero, por la situación al equipo que enfrenta, por la forma en que están bateando, etcétera, por cualquier otra razón, y es lo que ha podido dar el resultado en los últimos días. Espero que es una decisión que toman los coaches dentro del plan de acción para poder conseguir esas victorias. David, tenemos una pregunta, adelante.
Dave, los Leones del Escogido han sido el único equipo en jugar los 19 partidos establecidos en el calendario, es decir, han jugado de manera regular sin perderse ningún encuentro. ¿Qué tanto le ha beneficiado esto al equipo para conseguir la química y asegurar o dar un paso hacia la clasificación, que es lo que busca el dirigente con el conjunto?
Leones del Escogido is the only one team in whole league have played the 19 games scheduled in their calendar. So do you think this is a benefit for us, or do you think it's not?
I believe it's a benefit for us. And when I answer that question, it's got nothing to do with, you know, 12 games from now or a week and a half from now. Right now, because we've played 19 games, we are a better developed team, because the way you get better is play baseball, not practice it, not be. And I feel so bad for the players that got tested positive for COVID or have COVID. That's awful. Awful for their families, awful for them. But as far as a team, they can't get better when they're not on the field. They can't get better playing. We are a better team because we've had the opportunity to play 19 games. And so where that leads you to, you know, a week and a half from now, well, we're only concerned about tomorrow against Lasay as the visiting club. We're going to go 1-0 tomorrow, and we're going to take the 19 games of us developing better as a team, each person developing their own tools and skills to be a better player, and we're going to be ready to go out tomorrow and win a game and also develop.
Dice que definitivamente nos beneficia el haber jugado estos 19 partidos durante la temporada, porque esto ha permitido desarrollar a los jugadores y desarrollar el equipo en general. Esto ha permitido conocer las habilidades de los jugadores, saber qué pueden hacer, cómo lo pueden hacer, y que no hay una mejor manera para hacer crecer, para desarrollar un equipo, que jugar béisbol, que estar en el campo de juego. Que las prácticas sí son muy buenas, pero no funcionan para desarrollar un equipo y conseguir resultados. Que la mejor forma de conseguir victorias es estando en el campo de juego, y esto definitivamente nos ha beneficiado estar esos 19 partidos en el terreno. Última pregunta para Arvin González. He says, I'd like you to give us an update on the injuries.
How much time do we have?
General.
Because we had about 13, maybe even 15. The main ones are Ivan Castillo is coming along good. He's actually going to take some live BP tomorrow. Liberato's going to take live BP tomorrow. Julio Rodriguez had a full day of recovery. He got the job, but there's no concussion issues, which is really good for his life and career, and that's the most important thing. Just we were talking about COVID. Jimmy Paredes is coming along with his shoulder. Ale Mas's shoulder's coming along. I know I'm missing a few right now.
He's saying about Renquifo.
Oh, Renico, and that's a day-to-day thing. It's not a serious injury. There's no problem with him coming back. It's just that because it just happened a day ago, we're gonna be cautious for him. We want him ready for spring training, and we want him ready for 100% here so he can be ready for spring training. Renguifo is, it's not a serious injury, which is really good. Is there another one we should talk about?
She just mentioned that, but sobre Renquifo, dice que no tiene una lesión seria, dice que está tratando de estar aquí para estar 100% para los entrenamientos de primavera de Grandes Ligas. Tanto Liberato como Castillo estarán en la BP mañana. En el caso de Rodríguez, no tiene contusión en el rostro, en el donde recibió el pelotazo, y esos fueron los que nos actualizó, si no se me queda alguien, ¿verdad? Pero en general todos están en recuperación, sobre todo Castillo y Liberato, que estarán en el, irán al IBP mañana. Entonces, muchas gracias, Mr. Yao. Thank you very much.
Yes, yeah. I want to just say one thing is that, you know, in American football, they give a game ball. Melvin deserves a game ball today because that second question, that question that had two parts today, I must have gone on for about 8 minutes and he did one heck of a job. So let's give a big round of applause for Melvin
Thank
today.
You.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Giles. Gracias a todos ustedes. Se refería a la doble pregunta que hizo Arvin hace un ratito. Pero gracias por haber estado con nosotros esta noche. Hasta un próximo encuentro. Thank you very much.